And then economic juga boleh combine with government and legal political eh. So we mungkin boleh fokus kepada sini sajalah eh. So take advantage. Of course ada competitor ataupun benda tu tak stabil eh. Contoh keadaan dalam situasi sekarang. Sampai bila nak PKP tak stabil lah, become ancaman. Sampai bila kita kena standby. Lepas tu mungkin kita juga ada threat ataupun ancaman daripada kompetitor. Contoh bisnes makanan, banyak kompetitor. So we cannot avoid kompetitor. We cannot avoid ancaman. Okay, but we can reduce, minimize the impact. Sebab contohnya sampai bila nak PKP apa semua ni kan, MCO sambung 2 minggu. So kita yang buat bisnes ni tak tahu nak jalan macam mana, nak buka kedai tutup kedai, buka kedai tutup kedai. But we have to understand and we minimize the impact. Okay, opportunity tadi external yang saya kata pastel tu kan, political, economic, social, demographic, culture. Okay, sebab contoh just ni Malay people dia punya decision making untuk makan lain, Chinese people dia punya decision making untuk dia punya life ataupun untuk dia punya activities lain eh. So kita macam contoh bukan kata about between the difference between Malay, Chinese and Indian. Dalam Malay sendiri pun kita ada contoh Kelantanese. Dia punya culture lain, decision dia kena ada budu tiap kali makan. Tiap kali makan kena ada budu. Orang Kelantan contoh. So decision, cultural decision also create opportunity ataupun people made a decision based on their cultural factor.
Gua rasa excited.
Hello, this is not for Kuwait student. Please, for quick student, you may left. Please. For quick students, this is not for your... I believe for quick student, you must have another classes specifically to you. Because I'm going to deliver in our Bahasa, Bahasa Melayu. Later, you mungkin you complain you tak you don't understand the instruction because this purposely for local students, not for Kuwait students. So I'm going to conduct in Bahasa. So for Kuwait student, please. The class is you should attend another class specific conducted by Dr. Azri, if I'm not mistaken. How many of you are Kuwait students? Please leave. Yeah, this is not for, the class is not meant for you. I'm sorry. Okay. So dari segi technical, okay, governmental and competitor, kita already cover benda ni eh. Okay, then when we're talking about opportunity and threat, so we have to conduct, bila dia bersifat luaran, external, we have to conduct research and gathering the information outside, tengok industry analysis. Kenapa industry analysis? Kita kena tengok kita tu dekat mana, company kita tu, what you are and intended to move, right? So you, in the within your industry, for example, you are producing, you are manufacturing of electronic product. So you have to know where you are within your industry analysis. Within katalah you automotive, then you have to scanning. You ni dekat mana?
Where okay. Is automotive?
Hello, please, Kuwait student. I strongly suggest you to leave, please.
370.
Quick student, please. I believe for quick student, you there is another class for you conducted by another lecturer. Do you understand me? Quit student, it's not... Hello? Quit student, please. Huh? You should not attend this. This is for local students. Because I'm going to conduct in Bahasa. Okay. Okay. And then we go for internal. Okay, because kita tahu you should know your strength. You should know your weaknesses. Your strength in terms of financial ratio. Okay. Dari segi liquidity ratio. What is liquidity ratio? Bila sebut liquidity ratio. Kalau kita manusia, kita akan tengok blood pressure. Blood pressure tengok kita sihat ke tak. Company as easy, they look at the financial ratio. And one of the good to reflect a good company is a liquidity ratio. How macam mana you transfer the asset to the cash. You ada banyak asset, you ada building apa semua. Tapi bila you dalam keadaan masalah, dalam keadaan nak bayar hutang, you punya building asset tak boleh tukar to cash. To bayar hutang. You tak kuat. Tapi kalau you punya asset, you boleh jual dengan cepat, your liquidity ratio tinggi, you macam selamat lah. Dapat menyelamatkan. You punya performance matrix. Okay? Performance matrix is about, for example, bila you compare, you are manufacturing company of electronic. Your competitor boleh deliver new product dalam masa, boleh buat dalam masa 1 bulan. You 2 bulan. Atau dalam senang macam ni. Pizza Hut dengan Domino. Pizza Hut boleh hantar delivery 10 minit. Domino hantar delivery 30 minit. You kena compare performance metric macam tu. Okay. Employee turnover tinggi. Kenapa employee masuk hari ni, besok berhenti kerja? Okay, itu employee turnover. Okay. Masuk hari ni, bulan depan berhenti kerja. Tak boleh pakai. Tetapi kalau inventory turnover tinggi, adalah berbeza dengan employee turnover tinggi. Inventory turnover tinggi bagus. Kenapa? Raw material masuk hari ni, proses-proses, siap. Ha, itu industry average. Kalau company kita sebulan inventory turnover kena simpan dan baru jadi finished product, tak boleh. But, kita kena compare with our competitor. That's why we have to study the track ancaman. And then we collect the survey data. Okay. Bila kita buat projek, or when we have a strategy, or when we have any objective, or when we have any process, okay, or any apa saja yang kita punya aktiviti, okay, nak pergi makan ke, okay, aktiviti, mesti ada apa aim kita, right? Apa objektif yang kita nak capai? Apa yang kita nak cari? So, when semua projek dia akan, it's about completing the objective, completing the aim. Okay? So, projek in the enterprise project or business project is about survival, for example, completing the project. So semua itu akan ada objektif. Okay. Objektif, for example, to develop a building, to develop a bridge, to reduce customer complaint, to develop a software, itu adalah objektif. Tetapi bila kita nak develop objektif tersebut, apa yang kita perlu guna as a framework? Statement of objective should be specific. To develop a building. Okay. Measurable. Okay. To develop a building with two aircon. Okay. Two aircon within 6 months. Measurable and assignable. Assignable tu mungkin you boleh put as within 6 months, or you can put is for different department. Okay, adalah person in charge dia, assignable. Realistic. Okay, can you develop this building within 2 months? Tak logik ya. Selalunya at least 1 tahun kan nak buat rumah bungalow, rumah bungalow pun kan. So to develop bungalow mewah dengan dengan ada 7 aircon ke 8 aircon ke 70 kali 80 kaki ke dalam masa 1 tahun. Very specific. Measurable 1 tahun, apa karakteristik yang ada, kena ada contoh you letak lagi aircon tadi, color apa, lepas tu you kata mewah, 70 kali 80, itu akan jadi measurable. Okay, assignable within 1 tahun, ataupun by, you boleh kata by different apa specific dedicated department. Realistic and time related, should sound like that, huh? Okay, any company, any enterprise, when they go for the project, there are 3 types of the project. Okay, sama ada project itu mesti buat, must do project. Kena sekarang because of COVID-19, pandemic, apa semua kan. Jadi kena buat lah. Kena follow SOP. Kalau benda tu tak boleh physical, kena buat online. Nak buat online, kena ada a new infrastructure. You pun hire seorang untuk start that project. Okay, must do, must compliant to the needs, ataupun because of the survival of the organization. Kalau you tak buat, company tak boleh survive. Okay, or you nak buat compliant to the standard safety rules ISO 9001, that's a project must do. Nak business dengan China, okay, kena ada certain rule. Nak hantar export ke Singapore barang, kena ada certain, you kena lepas lesen A, lesen B, lesen C ke contoh. That you have to must do the project. Okay, then operational project. Operational project something like, for example, cost down, reduce cost, effective delivery. Okay, reduce time delivery. Itu adalah operational, something that you can reduce the operating cost. Strategic cost something about survival. Okay, to remain competitive in the market. You will new product development. New product. Come up with new product, new software, new package. Okay, kalau tak, customer akan pergi tempat lain. Asyik service macam ni saja, tak ada new package, tak ada new promotion. That become a strategic project to remain competitive. Okay, ada soalan? Abra Tazri ni Malay local student
Yeah, local.
Okay, so ada soalan ke? Ada soalan tak?
Tak.
So far so good. Boleh follow? Boleh eh?
Boleh.
You can interrupt me at any time. Kalau ada masalah tak apa ni tak faham ke apa nak so saya ulang ke please. No problem. Okay. Okay, this is just a short quiz ah. You nanti akan ada quiz pukul 7. Okay, ni macam main-main punya like tengok why Japan ah. In terms of resources ah, in terms of resources. US slow sini tetapi consume more resources at the end. Japan consume more resources at the beginning but towards the end dia reduce for new product development design manufacture assembly problem solving. So when I was R&D for more than 5 years with Panasonic company, I always travel to I'm working with Japan people travel there macam 6 bulan sebulan apa semua. Saya tengok orang Jepun the culture. They are sharing all the information, sharing all the testing. They consume more resources towards ni. Dan dia teamwork dia kuat. Teamwork macam apa? Teamwork lah saya boleh kata senang. Tetapi as simple, we know that Western people they are more individual basis kan. Contoh macam kalau kita tengok semua all invention, new product, new apa-apa semua new daripada daripada US. Okay, Google ke Facebook ke apa semua, but customize ataupun develop further with the Jepun jarang kita jumpa new things macam kalau kita tengok semua kan Yahoo apa semua tu daripada barat. Okay, apa yang saya nak kata tapi sekarang mungkin dah tak berapa nak betul lah. Okay, Jepun teamwork dia kuat. Jadi dia cari kesilapan, cari penyelesaian pada awal dan kalau ada masalah dekat akhir, tak banyak duit yang digunakan. Tetapi orang US Western is more individually, okay. Tetapi bila towards in terms of project development, towards akhir ni, mereka akan bila ada masalah, baru kita sedar. And then to fix that problem at the end, maybe need more resources, more time, more money to measure ataupun to overcome all the problem. Tetapi look at this as a general. Mungkin in the context of sekarang US tak tak apa ni, mereka juga also go for teamwork and they are good. Okay, what I can say is kalau kita jumpa masalah projek kita at the end towards the completion atau dah nak sampai projek akhir tu baru kita tahu ada masalah, nak fix itu sangat makan masa dan juga duit. Okay, back to how we move further about project selection So this is Palm Oil, their vision, okay, to become renowned information center. Mission, this is, I put one of the department in Palm Oil, or pusat maklumat sawit dia. So to preserve the industrial heritage, the vision, dia punya mission. Okay, this is actually the project yang saya handle with another group of student. Kalau kelas yang kecil, kelas yang 50 orang, 40 orang, normally I conduct with a team, a team activities or group activities. So apa yang kena buat adalah company mereka team activities mereka kena pilih. For example Proton. So study Proton punya vision, mission, strategy. Lepas tu try to understand, develop in the context of what are the strength of Proton, weaknesses of Proton, opportunity from the context of automotive company and then competitor threat, ancaman, then what are the external punya ancaman. Dan bila kita tahu benda-benda sini kan, so kita boleh kata okay, we know how to move next, moving forward. Okay, moving forward is about our plan A, plan B, plan C. It sounds that this is what we are going to do. Project A, project B, project C. This project consists of objective, right? So this project, of course, when we already develop, we understand ini, backward project itu akan support all the vision and missions. Okay, so suitable suggest what are the potential suitable project. Ini masalah kita. Okay, nak tahu macam mana, how to know the suitable project, how to suggest the best project. Ini yang akan kita buat, another tools yang kita akan guna to prioritize. We call it as weightage. Kita akan kasih weightage nanti, then dekat sini akan tunjuk the best project. Itu kita akan go after this. Okay, so dalam kita memilih macam mana kita nak select the best project, okay, sama ada kita decide, okay, how well a strategy or operation project fits organization strategy. Project itu yang kita tu of course akan support vision dan mission. So how well, how well tu of course kita akan ada kriteria apa yang kita nak, right? Okay, McDonald ke, kalau kita tengok McDonald, kita tengok dia punya produk more on burger development, okay, tetapi mereka sangat berjaya buat nasi lemak. Dan tengok KFC juga follow dengan nasi lemak atuk, dia tahu orang Malaysia suka nasi lemak, okay. Basically, okay, what niche of the KFC is about ayam. Semua product development dia more on ayam. McDonald mostly, okay, they go for burger, new burger, prosperity burger, apa burger, okay, because that is their niche to be competitive in the market. Okay, so kalau kita tengok Pizza Hut. Pizza Hut dia a very ambient dining, ambient yang kita pergi masuk kita rasa selesa. Apa competitor Pizza Hut? Domino. Tapi Domino adalah shop lock sahaja, dia bukan ambient macam Pizza Hut. Kenapa? Domino dia lebih target kepada delivery. Delivery is dia main target. Pizza Hut lebih kepada dining dalam restoran. So kriteria mereka ini adalah berbeza. Kriteria KFC adalah berbeza, kriteria McDonald's adalah berbeza. Tetapi mereka akan maintain competitive kriteria ini sebagai dia punya orang tak boleh challenge. Okay, so kriteria mungkin delivery, okay, quality of the product, price, okay, ataupun services. All of these kriteria dia akan kasih weightage 2.0. Kalau McDonald contohnya quality 3.0, all the criteria ini yang akan menjelaskan strategic operation fix to organization strategy. Dan ini juga kriteria yang akan menunjukkan weightage project mana yang kita akan ambil. Okay, tak apa, jangan risau, ini kita akan pergi pada table nanti. Okay, saya just explain awal-awal saja. Okay, so we apply weightage scoring model to bring the project, okay, to know the best project that we are going to select. Okay, so bila kita ada tools macam ni, dia akan reduce the number of wasteful project because we can identify, oh, ini project yang kita akan ambil. Okay, tak ada lah project yang akan going to waste ataupun pembaziran kepada company. Help identify the proper goals that suit the vision and missions of the company. And then kita tahu kadang projek ni orang akan conflict, orang akan dispute ke apa, you tak pilih projek saya, you pilih projek kerana somebody, kerana bla bla bla. Okay, tetapi kalau kita ada ini, scoring ini, people akan jelas why your project is being selected. Because of this and this and this. So it help everyone involved understand how and why their project is being selected. Okay, so this is what I'm talking about, project screening metric. So you have a project A, project B, project C, project D. So you put the weightage. Apa yang paling penting? Kalau untuk McDonald's, quality, delivery mungkin tidak. Okay, kalau Pizza Hut, quality. Kalau Domino, delivery is number one. Because itu yang dia compete. Make sure 10 minit dah sampai kepada customer bila order. So macam mana nak make it, make sure delivery sampai? Oh, semua kita punya rider adalah first class, Mak Rempit. Mak Rempit supaya semua sampai 10 minit. Okay, contoh ya, saya kena buat lawak lah sikit petang-petang kan. Okay, so you can define this weightage. Okay, based on your company competitive advantage ataupun the main criteria, you can put that. Okay, or based on the value at that time, the project, what actually. Okay, government put energy saving. So maybe you can draw, you can delete here. You put, okay, the project should sounds energy saving. Okay, the project tu sepatutnya ada sound sustainability. Boleh kekal lama, okay. Tak payahlah ini. You can put sustainability with a new scoring system. The project sepatutnya ada macam sound company social responsibility ataupun community. You kena, you put lah that criteria, CSR. Okay. The project macam sepatutnya ada ada sounds talent management ataupun value added. You put, then you put the criteria. So you select, you ada project 1, 2, 3. Oh, project ni dia tak bagus sangat lah untuk energy saving. Between scale 1 to 5 ataupun between scale 1 to 10, you evaluate. Okay, project ni bagus dan ada sound strategic fix to vision and missions, 8. Projek ni tak bagus untuk energy saving, tapi projek ni okay, sound very energy saving. Between scale 1 hingga 10, you put. Okay, you put all the scale, evaluation. You evaluation ini you tak boleh buat seorang. Okay, maybe wrong. You have to bring friends. 3, 4, 5 to discuss together. Okay, you put. Okay, then you calculate. 1 kali 2, 2 campur. 8 kali 3, 24 campur. 2 kali 2, 4 campur. 6 kali 2.5, berapa 15 campur 0, campur 6, campur 15, dapat. You go through all the project. Okay, this is the best project, nombor 1, kita akan select. Okay, ini nombor 2, kita akan select. Okay, this is nombor 3, kita akan select. Yang lain tu tak ada masa, tak payah buat. Okay, 1, 2, 3, projek. Okay, so, tak, ini ada projek satu lagi, projek N. Projek Nizam. N, nama saya Nizam. Ingat nama saya Nizam. Okay, kita pergi macam tu. Tetapi, persoalan lagi. Macam mana ni nak keluarkan jadi projek 1, projek 2 ni, nak keluarkan idea supaya timbul-timbul projek ni. Blur lah. Macam mana? Okay, then kita go further. Sama ada 1, you collect the proposal, the idea from your staff. Okay, the suggestion from your staff. Okay, project title about reduction blah blah blah. Okay, this is one of the way to collect the idea about the project. You sediakan format form, okay, about the proposal. So you, dia akan define lah siapa yang pemohon tersebut, semua akan tulis. Okay, yes, no, quality. Ni juga become a requirement, boleh jadi requirement of the importance of the project. Okay, itu. Okay, Okay, that's the proposal of project also come with risk analysis. Because project ini dia akan ada, nanti akan ada budget, ada funding. Okay, ada duit lah, grant. Macam juga kita dapat projek daripada kerajaan contohnya kan. Kerajaan akan grant you ataupun kasih you amount of money for to handle the project. Tetapi saya sebagai orang penilai dekat kerajaan yang sebelum I luluskan your project, saya akan tahu project you ni apa risk dari segi kewangan, dari segi teknikal, dari segi masa. Sebab saya tak nak funding the project yang objektif tak clear, masa tak clear, risiko untuk saya. Kan? You fail, saya punya duit juga gone. Okay. So, sekarang ni, satu, kita dapat idea daripada proposal. How to come up with projek satu, projek dua, projek tiga. Now, we move to the next level to understand about how to come up with a project that support our vision and missions. Okay? So, to understand that, we have to develop SWOT analysis. Okay? SWOT analysis is a strength about our internal weaknesses. Okay? Kita punya pekerja seumurnya orang muda-muda, between 40 hingga 50 tahun. Consider kuat lah. OUKM, Jabatan Kejuruteraan Mekanik Bahan, semuanya lecturer-lecturernya 50 tahun ke atas. Bila mereka pencen nanti, tak ada orang ganti, tutup JKMP. Ya. Contohnya. So, itu kita boleh analyse dari segi internal strength. Semua pekerja-pekerja kita memang cekap, talented, flexible, adapted dengan teknologi. Itu become our strength. Semua pekerja kita terdatang lambat. Itu juga weaknesses. So, kita analyse opportunity dekat luar. Selain kita sebut tadi pastel kan. Okay. Kita tengok dari segi interest rate, economic environment, interest rate sekarang. Okay, sekarang interest rate because of COVID-19, banyak dia reduce interest rate. Loan pun senang nak dapat with low interest rate. Personal loan sekarang 2.4 contoh. It's a good to get the personal loan. So that's become opportunity. Okay, we have to come up with a new product that can be delivered online. We have a new technology online. Kita ada Panda, kita ada Shopee, kita ada tu semua. That's become our opportunity. Okay. Tetapi ada juga ancaman. Competitor, exchange rate mungkin fluctuation because of economic situation. Currency kita tukar dengan US dulu RM4, sekarang RM4.5. By time kita nak bayar hutang nanti, kita need more ringgit to cover because of our reductions of currency exchange. Itu juga become our ancaman. So, company, the context of enterprise or business project, they have to understand this. They have to study this for their long term. Okay, because they are the long term objective, right? So, this is that support letter, vision and mission. Company establishment, dia ada objektif dia, dia ada vision mission dia, right? Dan dia dia ada survival strategy dia, okay? So they have to understand this. So they put all the strength, weaknesses, opportunity, threat. Dia punya strength, dia ada IT people, ramai IT people, and then dia punya company duduk dekat bandar with a good internet coverage. Now is about online delivery opportunity. Semua orang nak beli apa, cari Shopee, nak beli apa, cari Lazada, kan? Nak tengok apa, tengok Google, internet, tengok Facebook. This is opportunity with your strength. But with your opportunity you have, we call it SO strategy. Use strength to take advantage of opportunity. Okay. Then you know weaknesses. At the same time, walaupun you dalam situasi yang you punya pekerja with the good in terms of IT and then internet delivery ataupun online business, tetapi you ada weaknesses. Weaknesses dari segi people mungkin masalah pekerja yang tak boleh 24 hours ke bekerja. But when we talking about internet, it should be monitored 24 hours, data apa semua. You punya pekerja kena pukul 8, pukul 5 dah kena balik, tak boleh stay back apa semua. So you, then maybe you can think about how to overcome this. Okay, and then with the all the competitor around you, so many nowadays, a lot of IT company, okay? Or you ada strength tetapi you tahu ancaman. Ancaman dari segi mungkin tak ada duit, financial status, then you use strength untuk buat pinjaman, untuk working with IT company to support you. You join venture with the other company, work, you working as a partner dan sebagainya, you can use that. Okay, so kita SWOT analysis ini kita akan guna dalam project strategy development today. Develop the project. Kita juga akan guna untuk menepati nanti 2-3 minggu lagi saya juga akan ajar project risk. Dalam identify project risk nanti kita juga akan guna SWOT analysis. Okay, so better we understand today about what is SWOT analysis. So this is example another. So you punya key strength, you access working capacity. You have a lot of people, talent, skill. Okay, key external opportunity dekat luar. 20% annual growth in the cell phone industry. So you you acquire ataupun joint venture ataupun you beli company, you look at more on telecommunication company. Okay. Weaknesses, insufficient capacity exit of two major foreign competitor. So you pursue horizontal integration. This is susah sikit lah kalau nak faham. Contoh kita ambil yang lebih mudah. Okay, strong R&D. This is your strength because you punya people ada yang genius. Lepas tu track ancaman, decreasing number of young adults. Develop new product for older adults. Okay, because you are good in R&D. You have a very poor employee moral weaknesses, but there is a strong union activity. You tak boleh buang pekerja easily. Okay, walaupun dia poor moral. Tetapi ancamannya kalau you buang dia, dia mungkin akan saman you. Okay, sebab kita tak boleh buang pekerja easily. Kita kena tahu the right of the employee walaupun dia. Contoh, kita menghadapi banyak masalah kaki tangan kerajaan yang tidak perform. Ataupun yang very, very, very bad performance. Tapi tak boleh nak berhenti dia easily. Macam company swasta. Company swasta, you working or not? Okay, you stay or you go go out. Macam tu je. Tapi untuk kaitan kerajaan, dia kena ada banyak proses. So, mungkin dia demotivated because of kenapa. So, okay lah kita buat projek yang baru nak create motivation. So, we develop more benefit package to employee. So, apa projek yang kita nak buat? What types of the benefit package? Boss you kata, you fikir lah and this is your project. So pun you pun balik fikir. So this is become your project. You pun develop lah, start with objective. To develop a new benefit for staff for the staff. Macam tu eh. This is your objective. You can develop that as a new project. Okay, I bring you the example of this is Motorola. Okay, Motorola, how they come out with SWOT analysis. They put dia punya strength, technology innovative. Okay, and then they put opportunity 1, 2, 3, 4. strength 1, 2, 3 sampai 10. So they put it as strategy, opportunity, strategies. Sorry, strength, opportunity, strategies. Empowerment in Asia market. This is a new strategy that cover strength number 1, strength number 2, strength number 6, and then cover opportunity number 2. Strength 1, strength 2, strength 6, strength 8, strength 10, dan juga ni strength opportunity dia boleh cover internal growth opportunity. Okay, ini strategi dia. Satu strategi. Dua strategi boleh cover benda lain pula lah. Strategi nombor 3, strategi nombor 4. Okay, ni strategi semualah boleh cover weaknesses and opportunity. Weaknesses and opportunity. Ini adalah, strategi-strategi ini adalah projek nombor 1, projek nombor 2, projek nombor 3, projek nombor 4, projek nombor 5, projek nombor 6, projek nombor 7. Oh, banyaknya idea, banyaknya projek nak buat. Mana yang projek yang paling bagus? Contohlah. Okey, jom kita select mana projek yang paling bagus yang kita buat. Matrix tadi ni saya kita buat project screening matrix sekejap kita pun buat project screening matrix lah, kita transfer lah project 1, project 2, project 3, tadi project 4. Apa yang kita letak our criteria? Okay, sama ada sustainability, strategy fix, market demand, apa saja you can put. Yeah, you can put criteria delivery, quality, it sound cost down, it can help government punya initiative, so it help the environment. You can put anything, okay? Your criteria. Dan sejauh mana criteria itu yang paling penting? Kalau of course domino, domino criteria ada delivery lah. Okay, kalau delivery kita letak point 5. Okay. Point yang you nak letak ini tak ada masalah. Berapa? Okay, selalunya kita letak between 1 hingga 5 lah. Okay, ataupun kalau dalam 1 pun boleh 0.2, 0.1, 0.4. Total dia jadi 1 pun boleh. Jadi sini 0.2, 0.3, 0.2, 0.25. Okay, tak apa. Weightage kita letak berapa pun saja tak apa, tetapi dia menggambarkan kepentingan yang you nak pilih kriteria tersebut. Kenapa? Kita boleh letak based on our evaluation sebab kita akan buat standard evaluation untuk semua projek ini dan kita evaluate, kita kalilah. Kali, okey, kali ini kita campur. Okay, dapat value. So this is the best project. Okay, nampak 1 kali 2, 2. Campur 8 kali 3, 24. Campur 4. Campur 6 kali 5, 15. Campur 0, campur 6. Campur 5 kali 3, 15. Campur 15. Total 66. Okay, so sekarang kita dah tahu macam mana nak select project, macam mana nak prioritize project. So kita tahu apa tools yang kita nak guna, iaitu melalui strength, weaknesses, opportunity and threat. Kita buat SWOT. Okay, SWOT. Okay, strength, weaknesses, opportunity and threat. Ini untuk understand internal, our strength, our weaknesses internal. Dan kita nak tahu external influences. Okay, dari segi political, economical, social, technological, opportunity. Dari segi political, kalau sekarang nak buat business dekat Myanmar, Myanmar, political tak boleh. Oh, nak buat business dekat dekat Philippines contohnya, oh tak boleh, dia punya technological tak support, ataupun social people agak low dari segi education contohnya, oh economic tak stabil, currency tak stabil. So that's external that we have to understand. Kenapa? Kita kena faham internal influence ni, strength weaknesses, dan juga external luaran influences ini, kerana inilah akan mengganggu gugat objektif kita untuk melaksanakan projek. Okay, untuk mencapai objektif dalam melaksanakan projek. Okay, because projek kita buat bukannya 6 bulan. Projek rumah setahun, projek jalan raya 2 tahun, okay, projek buat software setahun, ada projek yang 5 tahun. So projek 5 tahun, 3 tahun ni banyak dia punya external factors, risk, risiko yang akan mengganggu dari segi stability ekonomi, currency, harga minyak, people, technology, acceptance. So we have to understand because projek kita 3 tahun, 2 tahun kan. So banyak indikator-indikator yang kita kena study, kena faham kriteria dia before we select the project. But the question, how to understand the criteria? Kita buat macam ni lah. Okay, then daripada kriteria itu kita boleh select the best project. So markah yang tinggi ini consider the most valuable and visible project should be selected. Okay, okay, move further about PEST. PESTEL, ada yang buat PEST saja, political, economic, ada buat PESTEL, acts, environmental, legal, ada buat STAPLER pun, ethical dimension, ada buat STAPLER include demographic, tapi demographic ni sebenarnya faktor kepada sosial ni. Okay, ethical ni boleh menjadi combination dalam political ni. Okay, ada buat steer, include regulatory factor. Okay, okay, social, technological, environment, economic dan regulatory. Tak apa, you can use. As long as you use, you apply similar framework to all project analysis. Okay, okay, PEST application level of cooperation, division, product, brands, new venture, you can apply at any level. Contohnya between the department, okay, to know the strength and weaknesses, new product development, because we also understand the market, the demand, the competitor, the demand of the product, okay, because it involve competitor punya analysis. New venture, new business, new investment, new marketing. Sebab tu juga dia boleh apply, saya kata tadi, untuk risk. Untuk risk, project risk. Acquisition, partnership juga kita boleh understand lah, sebab kita tahu weaknesses kita. Jadi kalau kita tahu weaknesses, okay, that's mean kita kena joint venture dengan company. Ataupun kita ni tak ada IT, okay, kita beli company, IT based company, partnership with IT, because kita tahu kita punya weaknesses. So we can do that, we can apply. Okay, that's what we call it part of strategic management, because it's a strategy analysis and should be managed properly. Complementary strategic tools to the PEST, we are using SWOT analysis, and juga ada, nanti kita akan tengok one of the part strategic management. Also we can use Porter 5 forces. Porter 5 forces juga kena understand supplier, consumer, demand, entrance. This is also outside, external, luaran punya application. That's why PEST juga can be applied to Porter 5 forces model. Okay, ni PESTEL lah, political, boleh tengok daripada service, daripada infrastructure, daripada tax, daripada regulation, economic growth rate, interest rate, inflasi. Semester depan, you akan belajar engineering economy dengan saya. So, engineering economy, kita one of the topic dalam engineering economy untuk JKMP mechanical dan pembuatan, kita ada engineering economy. So kita akan cover subject inflations. Inflation of interest apa ni? Currency. Currency ataupun duit apa kita panggil tukaran ya. Tukaran duit currency. Labor cost, business cycle, social include demography, education of the people, semuanya pandai komputer, semuanya belajar level university, culture, as I said, we have multi races, multi apa ni bangsa, income distribution sekarang is both husband and wife working. So buying power juga meningkat. Bila both by husband and wife working, dia akan create another issue. Contoh lebih banyak macam kindergarten ke ataupun care apa baby care center, because both working. Tapi akan create boost, akan boost the economy because of ada more buying power. Tapi people mungkin akan sibuk, akan sibuk. Jadi bila akan sibuk, tak ada masa untuk masak, okay, online, buat order online. And that's an opportunity, betul tak? Opportunity because of this situation, because people both husband and wife are busy, so akan create more opportunity for daycare center ataupun baby ataupun kindergarten ke, ataupun akan menyebabkan banyak online order, food order, fast food order kan, so orang lebih busy tu. So it's create opportunity because of the social factor. And then with emerging technology, R&D, communication, more government support dari segi financial to boost technology, go for clean environment, green green energy saving, so this create more opportunity for manufacturing company to produce energy saving product. Legal, okay, we are bounded actually based on SOP. Macam sekarang kan, SOP, apa patuh kepada apa penjarakan sosial lah, 3W lah, 3C lah. Itu adalah SOP, okay, yang menyebabkan our new system, our new business system, our daily activities, kita punya communication, interaction, meeting pun sekarang kena buat online kan. So dia create another because of new SOP, create another opportunity perhaps. Kita kena fikir apa opportunity yang akan mungkin terjadi, okay, dari segi mungkin dan ecological ataupun environment kan. Kita boleh letak resource management, energy availability, kita ada internet. Kalau kita tengok Celcom, masa MCO hari tu kan, banyak opportunity apa ni, internet bayar murah ke, more coverage, banyak opportunity yang diberi, okay, so we can grab that, okay, then we can create a new project. Itu yang saya kata tadi, Michael Porter Five Forces juga guna PESTEL. PESTEL kita tahu is about luaran punya assessment, luaran punya assessment. So dia tengok ni extra knowledge saja, sebab we can use this to create a new project, new project. Okay, contoh dia buat competitor. Kita tahu PESTEL, kita tengok luaran, macam track ancaman, ancaman opportunity and track, okay, track ancaman luar. Ancaman luar, katalah you punya business adalah food, delivery food. Mungkin banyak nanti akan competitor akan tiru you punya idea. You letak kek ke dalam Instagram, dalam Facebook ke apa semua kan. Oh, it become the idea for the other business, for the other people. So you fikir macam mana saya nak supaya orang tak boleh tiru kek saya ni. Okay, you mungkin akan ada signature ke, you akan protect your product, make it different with the other people, you punya product tu make ada advantage dari segi harga, dari segi delivery, dari segi decoration, dari segi quality, macam contoh secret recipe kan, katalah kek dia sedap dan apa semua, people tak boleh nak copy. People tak boleh nak buat kek yang sama. Contoh you memang terkenal you punya kek ke you punya produk yang competitor tak boleh copy. So mungkin that's an advantage yang you dah develop dari segi quality, dari segi delivery. People, the other competitor tak boleh challenge. That mean you already made a barrier to entry for a new competitor. But before you achieve that, of course, you study with a new project macam mana kita nak buat, make it our kit special, kita punya delivery orang tak boleh nak compete, kita punya harga orang tak boleh nak compete, okay, kita mungkin ada promotion, kita mungkin ada buat web page, kita boleh buat...
Aku dapat masuk.
Masuklah. Sorry, saya suka buat joke. You are welcome to discuss. Okay, so you dah develop benda tu. Okay, you punya development, you punya idea itu adalah the project, right? Am I right? Because you ada objective nak capai. Dan the project support your business survival. Your project support your vision, your missions. So this is sounds that how to select the project that remain and make it sustainable and competitive. Itu kita punya idea. So sebanyak objektif kita, okay? Tajuk kita adalah project selection, project strategy, strategic management. Okay? So project selection kita dah tahu macam mana. Kita guna kriteria tadi, project selection matrix. Tetapi list of the project 1, 2, 3 tu macam mana nak keluarkan idea nak timbul. Kita kadang nak buat apa, project saya ni final year project tak tahu nak buat apa. So how to come up with the project? So you understand tadi SO strategy, W weaknesses opportunity strategy. So we know. So project strategy we already cover, project selection we already cover, strategic project management adalah tools because it's combinations of arts and science. Okay, combination with the soft skill and hard component ataupun engine, hard skill. Jadi hard skill ini ataupun science adalah tools. Okay, tools ataupun machine. So you know already SWOT. SWOT adalah tool. Pester adalah tool. Strategic management, Michael Porter 5 Forces tool. So you already know the sciences component of strategic management. But what is soft skill? Soft or arts, okay? Combination of arts and science, right? So arts itu adalah knowledge, adalah managerial skill, communication skill, leadership skill yang you ambil bila you understand completions of the tools ini, Michael Porter 5 Forces, SWOT tools ni, you get the idea. You know how to speech, you know how to pitch, you know how to deliver. You know how to communicate. So it's strategic management is combinations of art and science in formulating, in organizing, and in delivery or in managing all your actions towards what you are going to be. So we understand our SWOT, understand our weaknesses, understand our strength, opportunity and threat that help us, menolong kita untuk moving forward. What is moving forward? Moving to the next level of our strategy lah. So with all of our kerja lah, objective semua project, activities. So we understand now how to select the project. Okay?
Oh.
Atau another strategic management tool, we call it as a blue ocean strategy. Okay. What is blue ocean strategy? Okay. Kita mungkin buat bisnes kita ni dalam, okay, nasi campur. Nasi campur tu semua, ramai orang nasi campur already. Oh, tak boleh. Kita kena create satu bisnes yang orang lain tak boleh compete, a new ni, dan with a less competitor, but masih banyak demand dan customer. So, we move from red ocean strategy to blue ocean strategy by using reduce, create, raise, eliminate. Okay. Apa yang A. Asia buat bila dia guna BOSS ni? Okay, dia raise quality of safety point to point direct flight. Kalau kita tengok A. Asia, dia tak ada macam transit. Dia hanya 1.2, okay, dia tak ada katalah Kuala Lumpur tu Sabah, tetapi akan stop dekat Kuching dulu. Tak ada. Dia flight direct Kuala Lumpur to KK ataupun another flight Kuala Lumpur to Kuching. Tapi Mas Malaysia Airline, dia akan buat, dia ada transit boleh dulu ke Kuching sebelum ke Sabah. Tetapi itu akan delay the time. Orang tak suka, businessman selalu nak cepat lah, kan, tak, kan dia tak transit mana-mana. So dia raise dia tingkatkan quality of the safety. Dia create dulu Air Asia yang memperkenalkan online beli tiket. Okay. Sebab bila dia buat online beli tiket, dia boleh jual murah. Okay. Sebab tu dia put everyone can fly. Tiket dia murah. Kita nampak benda tu eh. Kita nampak, oh, tiket Air Asia murah. Nak murah macam mana? Beli online. Beli online maksudnya actually the cost of that operating transfer to you. Okay. Kita nak masuk online, kita kena ada komputer, kita kena ada elektrik, kita kena ada internet, dan kita kena ada printer. Masuk, kita sendiri masuk, select dan kita print. Okay, jadi dia boleh jual murah lah, sebab katalah kalau you pergi office, ticketing office, dia kena sediakan office, kena sediakan pekerja, kena sediakan komputer, kena sediakan printer, you nak pergi beli tiket, right? Of course, semua tu adalah kos kepada Air Asia. Jadi, dia tak boleh jual murah sebab dia kena tanggung kos tu. Tetapi sekarang, bila dia transfer the cost to you, you buy it online by your own, actually you yang tanggung kos tu. Okay? Tapi, you nampak harga tiket murah. Right? Ha, kan? Dan, dia offer you all beli tiket yang murah, bukan minggu depan nak fly. Hari ni beli tiket yang murah, tak, masih lagi harga mahal. You beli tiket yang murah tu sebulan in advance, 2 bulan in advance. Jadi you dah bayar in advance. Okay, dia dah collect duit you 2 bulan lebih awal tanpa memberi servis kepada you. Eh? So maksudnya katalah saya buat kan, buat tu. You all semua 400 ni kan? Okay, saya tak beri lagi servis pada you tapi saya dah collect duit you sekarang, RM1. Kalau saya ada 2 juta orang, saya dah ada RM2 juta. Duit itu saya boleh manipulate. 2 bulan lagi baru you nak fly, kan? Saya 2 bulan ni saya boleh manipulate buat business. I can generate more money from that. Instead, kalau saya buat loan dekat bank, saya kena bayar interest. Kan? Saya duit 2 juta tu. Tapi kalau saya dapat daripada you, free. Right. Sebab itulah apa ni, kes-kes macam ni memang dia akan psychologically you nampak murah. Okay, sebenarnya dia create keuntungan from the other side. Macam touch and go, you nak guna, you kena prepaid kan, kena masuk, kena bayar dulu baru you boleh guna touch and go. Jadi you mungkin guna bulan depan tapi you dah bayar touch and go dia punya ni you top up dalam kad dia RM20, RM30. Kalau saya ada 1 juta orang, saya boleh dapat senang-senang 30 juta. Kan? Lepas tu, kalau Air Asia, you beli harga tiket sebulan lebih awal, kalau you tak fly, sekian terima kasih. Duit tu hangus. So that's a idea, strategi yang dia buat sebenarnya kita tak nampak. Okay, web registration. Okay, kalau you nak cepat, tak apa. You kena ambil green lane ataupun hot lane. Kena bayar lagi. Bayar tambah. Last-last harga yang you bayar tu lebih kurang sama je dengan harga Malaysia Airline. Tapi dalam kepala kita dah nampak Asia low price, harga murah kan, kita selalu nampak macam tu. Psychologically, mereka dah beli kita punya minda. Dia connected, Asia juga connected dengan Tune Hotel. So all this change, all dia punya chain connection dia punya supplier ni, chain dia ni, sebenarnya create more profit. So dia reduce airfares, dia reduce capital. Contoh, dia tak perlu sediakan food. Okay, you beli kena beli atas kapal terbang ataupun online. Kalau you beli, dia menggalakkan kita order makanan food through online tu, kerana kita selalu kita dah let bayar satu dalam kes tadi. Dia juga boleh buat planning, berapa orang nak apa semua, sebab dia boleh juga mengeluarkan pembaziran dari segi penyediaan makanan. Staffing, kalau Malaysia Airline, okay, dia reduce. Kalau Malaysia Airline dalam kes ini, staffing, Malaysia Airline KL ke Kuching, okay, dia punya steward and stewardess dia akan stay dekat hotel, flynya besok balik with another flight. Okay, make a stay overnight. Tetapi Air Asia, staff yang sama, steward, stewardess, okay, pergi ke Kuching. Lepas tu katalah kapal terbang tu balik semula ke KL, dia balik semula ke KL, pergi pindah staff yang sama. So they can reduce. So itu antara. So when they come up with all this idea, of course this is about project. This about strategy. So that's why flying daripada SWAT, Pestle, Michael 5 forces, we also can use BOSS to get a new idea, strategy or the project that we can go to select the project. So with that's why they call it a blue ocean strategy, because create uncontested market space, make their competition relevant, create and capture new demand, break the value cost trade-off. So dia tak nak compete ramai-ramai with the less ataupun resources ataupun macam very competitive. They create a new business yang tak boleh orang compete, that remain, make it AirAsia business. So they come up with a new project, okay, innovate and pursue new opportunities perspective, okay, rather than they compete in a major normal market share. You can go that. Okay, so again, okay, and just review. Okay, we list all the weaknesses. We call it harmful and helpful opportunity and strength. This is internal, this is external opportunity. We list, we put our advantage of our strength, we minimize of our disadvantages, we minimize our threat, and we try to get a good opportunity to SWOT. And then we list all the SO strategy, WO strategy, all this strategy become our project. Okay, so this is project lah. Okay, working with external professional. okay, this is our new idea, this is our new project. Objective to get more expertise or support from external. That's our objective. So we have a lot of project here. Tak tahu macam mana nak pilih. Then we have a project prioritizing matrix, with all the criteria and with all the weightage kita kira. Okay, number sini yang paling besar kira the best project. So bagus macam ni kerana apa? Tadi you can defend, okay, why your project is a good should be selected. Reduce the conflict, reduce the dispute. People understand why their project being rejected. Increase the communication, because people understand. Working environment is also good, okay, because no dispute. Okay, ni SWOT lah. So all of this become we can turn to the strategy. This is another example you can go through, to understand. And this is, like I said, Motorola. So strength, opportunity become strategy. So this is a project. Project 1, project 2, project 3, project 4. So project 4 ni untuk cater with strength number 1, strength number 5, strength number 10 with the opportunity number 1, number 4 dan number 5. So okay, tetapi macam mana nak pilih the best project sini? Kita buat matrix sini. Okay, matrix weightage is up to you. You can develop this weightage from 1 to 5 or within dalam 1 tu mungkin 0.2, 0.3, tapi the total tu jadi 1. Boleh juga macam itu. Then the weightage ini akan menggambarkan kepentingan. More higher, that mean more important. Kalau you become delivery itu is the main yang you kena pertahankan untuk survive in the market, you put more weightage. Sebab kalau project tak support delivery, gone. So you give more weightage for delivery. So you select and you can get the best. Itu buat. So I also provide you, I am going to share with you after this with PDF. Another example, project selection matrix solution ni consider project ataupun strategi A, project easy to implement C1, feasible C2, cost effectiveness C3, time C4, easy to maintain C5, 1 hingga 10. 10 good. So this project, okay, sound very good lah. Okay, 2. So you campur 5. You juga boleh campur macam ni. 5 campur 3 campur 5 ni, total dia akan 18. So this is the project yang kita akan select. Okay, ataupun you buat ini, 4 kali 11. Okay, 4 kali 11 ini 44. 3 kali 6 ini, because this is the weightage yang you put, okay, 18. 4 kali 4 16. 6 kali 4 24. Campur 44 campur 18 campur 16 campur 24, 102. Projek yang lain 88. Okey, kita pilih projek ni, projek A. So bila kita pilih projek A ni kan dia ada objektif kan. So objektif tu kita buatlah to complete blah blah blah, to develop blah blah blah, to maintain blah blah blah. That's our objective. From sini kita buat objektif, okay. Dan of course daripada objektif tu kan kena ada SMART, SMART, specific, measurable, attribute, assignable, time dan realistic, okay. Dan objektif itu ada kriteria, kriteria itu adalah deliverables. Yeah, apa yang kita nak capai. Kalau you cakap rumah, you are going to develop a bungalow with atap dia warna biru, glasses dia macam mana, aircon dia macam mana, keluasan dia macam mana, itu adalah deliverables. Okay, itu adalah yang perlu kita ukur untuk measurable, untuk yang kita capai, menunjukkan bahawa kita complete objektif itu dengan capai all the deliverables. Okay, ni another example. 9 kali 2, 18. Campur 5 kali 5, 25. You campur, you dapatlah markah sini. You can use this condition. So itu saja. So any questions? Saya save ini dalam PDF kejap. Ada soalan ke?
Ini nota ini akan upload dalam UKM folder.
Saya upload sekarang. Saya okay, juga okay. Sekejap, saya juga share dekat you dekat sini. Dekat dekat ni. Chat room, chat box. Okay, chat box saya upload sekarang. Chat box. Sekejap eh. Sekejap, where is our chat box? Okay, I'm going to upload. You have been muted. You boleh dengar saya kan?
Boleh.
Okay, sekejap.
Kena boleh, doktor.
Okay. Sekejap, saya try upload. Kenapa tak boleh upload? Tak boleh upload melalui chat box lah. Okay, saya saya tak record dulu. Kita recording ni kita stop. Saya stop record. Sementara kita tunggu Dr. Niza pukul 7 nanti ada quiz. Dr. Niza akan join. Saya stop record. Stop recording. Okay. And then I go to chat box. Okay. You have been muted, so you cannot start a conversation. Saya boleh upload selalunya nota melalui chat box ni.
Upload UKM folio dulu.
Saya upload dalam UKM folio sekarang . Okey, sementara kita tunggu Dr. Niza, dia kata dia nak buat quiz pukul 7. Kita tunggu. Oh, UKM folio pun dah new features . Okay, sambil-sambil tu ada soalan? Ada soalan?
Tapi sepukul tu nanti tak ada time frame.
Okay. Pengurusan projek. Okey, saya sekejap saya Okay, saya tulis nota. Hari ni berapa bulan? 8 April. Saya tajuk project selection. Project selection. Okay, for your measure. Okay, saya nota tajuk project strategi. Project selection. Project strategy and selection. Cuba tengok, dah ada ke? Saya dah upload.
Ada, doktor.
Ada . Okay.
Ada, doktor.
Okay, good. Okey, kita tunggu Dr. Niza lagi 2 minit. Ada quiz.
Jalan serentak ke?
Saya tak tahu nanti sekejap eh. Dia kata dia akan join pukul 7. Okey. Bila Dr. Niza dah ada dalam ni ke? Tak ada, dia belum respon. Macam mana so far boleh faham eh? And they are more interesting when I share with you later about Project RIS.
Apa?
Ini adalah nota untuk nanti Project RIS. Dah ada gambar, banyak picture eh. Nak faham apa itu RIS. Macam tadi, saya start dengan nak faham apa itu strategi. So, untuk Project RIS, saya akan start dengan nak faham apa itu RIS. Ni macam orang boleh kerja macam ni. This is all RIS. Apa glass bridge dekat China. So, ini untuk Project RIS juga saya akan cover. Dan Project RIS juga nanti dia akan guna SWOT. SWOT untuk kita identify risk. Okay. So untuk ini kita jumpa lagi nantilah 2 minggu lagi. Okay, Dr. Niza mana?
Ya, saya. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam. Niza. Niza, apa Niza ambil lah. Sebab okay. Saya start pukul 5 tadi tak sempat. Tu direct sini.
Tak apa, okay.
Tak sempat.
Thank you, Prof. Tak apa.
Okay, thank you. Saya left eh.
Okay.
Saya leave the meeting. Okay, Alright, thank you. Okay. Kelas baru habis je.
Okay. Saya masuk room salah tadi.
Baru je habis. Memang baru je ngam-ngam. Okay lah. Baik. Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, bye. Okay, good evening everybody. My name is Niza Royani. I'm from the Jabatan of Kejuruteraan Mechanical and Manufacturing, Mechanical dan Pembuatan. Kejuruteraan Mechanical dan Pembuatan. Untuk semester ni saya tak mengajar sebab saya dapat task lain. So, untuk hari ni kita akan ada quiz 2. Semua aware ada quiz 2? E-quiz.
Yes, doktor.
Okay, bagus. Okay. So saya harap you all faham apa yang Prof bagi lecture tadi. Dan kita akan buat e-quiz ni khas untuk topik hari ni sajalah. Okay. So quiz ni saya buka daripada pukul 7 daripada sekarang sampai pukul 10. Okay, from 7. Sorry, may I know anybody who doesn't understand bahasa Melayu? It's okay. I open the... Sekejap. I open the quiz from 7 to 10 p.m. Okay. And the quiz is on iFolio. UKM Folio. So whenever you have the time from now on to 10 o'clock, you can attempt the quiz. Okay. But once you have started the... once you start to answer this quiz, you have only 20 minutes to answer, yeah. And then there are going to be 13 questions, and the first question is going to be on the integrity, yeah, integrity on the exams. So the actual questions will be only 12 questions. So all the instructions has been put on the you can follow as well, and you only can attempt once, yeah, and you cannot go back to the previous question. So you only have to move forward, not backward, yeah. Okay, and you need calculator, yeah, to answer the quiz as well.
So make sure that you have attempted 13, all the 13 questions, and submit lah, submit as usual. Any questions? Tak ada eh?
Is it all objective?
Yes, all objective.
Alright, thank you.
Okay, so you only have 20 minutes, but the quiz is open from now on to 10 p.m. Any other questions?
Sorry, doctor. I've checked in UKM folio, but I didn't see the quiz question.
Okay, let me check again. UKM.
Hey, doctor.
How about the others? Have you checked? Can you see the question?
Tak ada juga, doktor.
Saya pun tak ada, doktor. Okay, saya ni.
Saya pun tak ada, doktor.
Okay. Okay, sekejap eh. Give me 5 seconds to check. Okay. Sekejap eh. Okay, can you see now? Refresh your page. Can you see?
Yes.
Okay, good. So please make sure that you are ready. Make sure that you are ready. And then start to attempt. Okay, apa lagi soalan? Ada soalan? Tak ada eh? If you have any other, if you have any problems, please contact me directly through email, yeah, because my email will go into my phone, so the email will go straight to my phone. Okay, so if you have any questions or any problems, please contact me directly, yeah. Tak payah, jangan contact pencara lain. Okay, all the best.
Mama.
Okay.
Okay.
Ini siapa? My student. Yeah, my student. Okay. Bye-bye. So we
actually... Thank you, doctor.
Okay, so we dismiss
you. Thank you, doctor.
Have a good night.
Okay, thank you, doctor.
Time answering the
thank you, doctor.
Okay.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you, doctor.
Thank you, doctor. Bye.
Thank you, doctor.
Bye.
Assalamualaikum, doktor.
Waalaikumsalam.
Arigato.
Thank you, doktor.
Bye.
Oh, bye.
Bye.
Bye.